Good morning, boys. We are dealing about the lesson Plant Kingdom. Under this, what we have learned about Thallophyta, Bryophyta, and Pteridophyta. So, under Thallophyta, what we have seen about algae, bacteria, and fungi, and then about Bryophyta, Pteridophyta. So in these topics, what we have learned about their structure and their classification, their economic importance. Now we move on to gymnosperms. Next division is gymnosperm. Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, and then gymnosperms. When we take about gymnosperms, they are known as naked seeded plant, because in them the ovule is not surrounded by ovary. What is ovule? Where do we find? We find this ovule in the flower, and then this ovule is not surrounded by the ovary. So this is known as, this is ovule and then this is ovary. That is, the seeds are exposed. They do not have any outer cover. So naked means opened, open seeded plants. So their ovule is not surrounded by ovary. So the gymnosperms are also known as naked seeded plants. When we take about gymnosperm, they show little characteristic feature like higher plants, because in them the vascular system is present. In this vascular system, the xylem and the phloem are present. This shows the higher plants, the higher plant characteristics. Phloem, xylem, everything is present. Then xylem, tracheids are present, and then vessels, phloem, xylem, everything is present. So as these characters are shown by them, they are considered to be little higher organism. Then when we take about gymnosperms, they are naked seeded plant, and then vascular system is present. And then about classification, the classification consists of four types, that is cycadales. First one, cycadales. Then when we take about cycadales, these gymnosperms, these cycadales plant, what they show mean, they are palm like appearance, palm tree. They show the leaves are found at the crown like structure at the top. Then they show the sporophyte here. And then when we take about leaves, they are pinnately compound like this. So they are looking, they are giving the appearance like the palm tree. Example, cycas plant. So when we take about cycadale, this is one of the plant cycadales classification under gymnosperm, and then they show the palm like appearance, that leaves are pinnately compound, and then there is a sporophyll. The sporophyll consists of the spores here. When we take about gymnosperm, the gametophyte is followed by sporophytic generation. The sporophytic generation is not differentiated into leaf, stem and root. So this is one of the characteristic feature of gymnosperm. The gametophyte followed by sporophyte, and then this sporophyte is the dominant character here. This sporophyte is not differentiated into stem, leaf and root like structure. So this is about the characteristic feature of gymnosperm. Under gymnosperm, cycadale is one of the classification. When we take about cycadales, they show palm like appearance, and then the leaves are pinnately compound, and then they contain, the sporophyll contains the spores. Example, cycas. The next comes the cycadales, then gingkoales. This gingkoales include, here the leaves are fan like structure. The leaves shows the appearance of the fan like structure. And then this gingkoales, they are only living plant. They are considered to be living plant. And then this gingoils, where they show mean, they show the leaves fan like appearance. The leaves are appearing to be the fan like structure, and then they show some unpleasant smell is there. So this is only the living generation. Then next, coniferales. This coniferales shows the cone like trees, and then they are evergreen. Evergreen cone like appearance, cone shaped like this, and then the leaves are needle like structure. They have the needle like leaves, cone shaped tree, and then needle like structure. Leaves are needle like structure. Example, pinus is the example. Third one, coniferales. Next, knee tails. When we take about knee tails, they are showing some little advanced character. The tree like appearance, they show evergreen tree like structure, evergreen trees. And then here the leaves are, there is no, the sporophyte does not contain the leaf stem like structure, but here the ovule is naked seed. Ovule is not surrounded by, the ovary is not surrounded by the, ovule is not surrounded by the ovary. So, but it somewhat shows the advanced character like angiosperms. So these are the four type of classification. Cycadales. Cycadales show palm like appearance, and then gingoils, they are only living species, and then their leaves are appear to be fan like structure. Coniferous, evergreen cone like trees, and then they consist of needle like leaves. Example, pinus. When we take about knee tail, they show some advanced angiospermic character. They are evergreen tree like structure. Some of them appear to be tree like character. So these are about the classification. When we take about gymnosperm, they are naked seeded plant. Here the ovule is not surrounded by ovary, so their seeds are exposed. And then the gametophytic generation is alternate with the sporophytic generation. Here also alternation of generation is seen. So one generation is followed by next generation. That is alternation of generation, as we have seen in bryophyta and pteridophyta. And then here the sporophyte is not differentiated into leaf, stem and root. Here the gymnosperm consists of the vascular tissue. Then xylem and phloem are present. They show the advanced character. Then about types, classification. Then we move on to economic importance. This gymnosperm is also useful for to us. Example, pinus tree. For what purpose they are used? They are giving wood. From them, the wood is considered for making paper industry. The pinus and the agathis is used to make paper industry. Their wood is useful for making paper industry. And then the soft wood from cedrus and agathis, they are used for packing and the plywood construction. Construction, packing, plywood industries. In these fields, these cedrus and the agathis are useful. Then turpentine is an oil which is extracted from the resins of pinus, in which it is used, useful for making paint. And then the medicine which is obtained from turpentine used to get relief from pain and bronchitis. What is bronchitis? It is the disease which is considered in, which is included in the lungs, bronchitis. So the turpentine, the oil which is extracted from the pinus tree, the resins of pinus, it is used in paint industry. And then medicine which is extracted from turpentine, it is used to relieve the pain and bronchitis, the disease related to lungs. Then the seeds of the, some seeds are also edible. And then ephedrine, it is one of the alkaloid medicine. It is one of the medicine which is extracted from ephedra. It is one of the gymnosperm plant, ephedra. The alkaloid which is extracted from them, the medicine which is prepared from them, it is used for respiratory problem. It is used to cure some respiratory problem. And then tuberculosis, in these, this ephedrine is useful. Then Araucaria bidwilli, it is one of the gymnospermic plant which is used for ornamental, which is used as an ornamental plant. So these are all about the economic importance of gymnosperms. The wood which is from pinus tree, useful for making paper industry. Then the soft wood which is from cedrus and agate is used for making plywood construction and then packing and then for construction purpose. The turpentine from them, the oil is extracted which is used in paint. And then the medicine which is extracted from this turpentine, the resins of pinus, used to cure pain. It get rid of pain and bronchitis. See, some of the seeds are also edible. Edible mean eatable, we can eat. Then ephedrine, it is an alkaloid which is prepared from ephedra, which is used to cure some respiratory problem. And then Araucaria bidwilli, it is one of the ornamental plant used to beautify for beautiful purpose. So these are all about gymnosperm, naked seeded plant, vascular tissue present, and then about their classification we have seen. Next we move on to angiosperms. These angiosperms are considered to be higher plants. They are higher plants because in them the vascular tissue is present. Angio means closed or open, closed or box. Then sperm means sperma, means seed. The seeds are closed. So the ovule is enclosed by the ovary. Ovule is enclosed by a cover called ovary. So they are considered to be angiosperm, closed or box. The seeds are within the box. When we take about angiosperm, they show many habits, that is herbs. Some of them are herbs. Eggplant is an example. Eggplant or brinjal plant. Then shrubs, hibiscus. Some of them are trees, mango tree, like that. So they show different types of habits. Habits mean the trees, whether it is herb, shrub or trees. So angiosperm are known as closed seeded plant. So and then in them they show many habits. Herbs, they may be some very short plant, herbs. Next is shrubs, very high plants, that is trees. So these are all the habits shown by the angiosperms. When we take about angiosperms, they show two types of classification. That is dicotyledons and monocotyledons. When we take about dicotyledon, di mean two cotyledons are present. What is meant by cotyledon? It is the leaf which is found in the seed. Okay, the seed contains the leafy portion, that is known as cotyledon. As it contains two cotyledon, it is known as dicotyledon. Mono means single. Example for this is bean. If we take bean seed, we can split them into two. That is dicot is there, two cot is there. But if we take paddy, we cannot split them into two. So it is single cotyledon, it contains two cotyledon. Monocot contains single cotyledon. Then it is about the leaves. When we take about the leaves of dicotyledon, they show reticulate venation. This is known as reticulate venation. Venation means the type of vein, how they are arranged on the leaf. So if we take dicotyledon plant, their veins are like this. They show reticulate venation. But if we take monocotyledon, example in grass, if we see the grass, the venation is like that, parallel venation. It is reticulate venation. It shows parallel. Like in banana, we can see this type of venation parallel to each other. Banana. So when we take about the structure of the leaf, in dicot we can see the reticulate venation, but in monocot we can see the parallel type of venation. And then when we take about the root of dicotyledon, they show tap root system. Dicot shows tap root system. Primary root is there, again it is divided into tertiary and secondary. But in monocot it is considered to be fibrous root system. This is known as fibrous root system. Tuft of root has arises from the underground soil. This is known as fibrous root system. So if we take dicotyledon, it is the root is known as taproot system. If it is in monocot, it is fibrous root system. We can find this type of root in grasses. Then here we can see all the plant are taproot. Dicotyledon plant, almost all of them shows this type of taproot system. Then when we take about the type of pollination, here the pollination happens by means of wind, insect, they are the pollinating agents. But if we take monocot, wind is only the reason. They may be pollinated by either by wind or by insect or by human beings. All are considered to be the pollinator. But here, being very light in weight, the flowers are carried out by the wind. So wind is only the pollinating agent in monocotyledons. When we take about monocotyledon, the flower is considered to be tetramerous. In dicotyledon, the flower is tetramerous, 4, or it may be pentamerous, 5. Five cotyledons are there. And then if we take monocot, it is trimerous, only 3, like this. Then the calyx and the corolla are seen. Calyx means the flower, which we have seen in colored portion. Then corolla means the sepal. Here below the flower we can see. So this is calyx, this is corolla. So the calyx and the corolla are present in dicotyledon, but they are not absent in monocotyledon. But they are present, but not seen like that. So the flowers contain tetramerous, 4 type of 4 cotyledons are there. Here it is only 3. So these are all about the structure of the monocot and dicot. In differentiate we can see this is the classification under angiosperm. The angiosperms are considered to be the closed seeded plant. And then if we take angiosperms, the vascular system consists of the xylem and the phloem. The xylem consists of all the 4 parts, that is xylem and the phloem are present. What are they? They are the vascular system used for conduction of food material and water material. The xylem consists of tracheid, fiber, xylem parenchyma, xylem fiber, and then vessels. Xylem parenchyma, xylem fibers, phloem consists of phloem parenchyma, tracheids, etc. So these are the structure about the angiosperm. When we come to the classification, it is divided into dicotyledon and monocotyledon. Here single cotyledon, 2 cotyledon is present, but in mono means single cotyledon is present. When we take about the leaves, they show reticulate venation. Many branches are seen, but here it is only parallel venation. No branches are seen, parallel venation. When we take about the root, they show taproot system. In monocot, it is considered to be fibrous root system. Grasses are example. Here pollination happens by means of either by wind, insect or by human beings. Here it is happened only by the means of wind. The flowers are tetramerous or pentamerous, 5 or 4. Here it is only trimerous. So these are all the differences between the classification of angiosperms. So next we move on to taxonomy. What is meant by taxonomy? The classification of plant according to the laws. The plants are classified according to the law. So taxes mean classified. Plants are classified according to their law. So the taxonomy was first introduced by Augustine. Augustine Pyramus Decandolle. He only classified the taxonomy. He gave the classification. And according to his classification, how the plants are, they show how the plants are first described. And then they are identified. Then classified. So this is about taxonomy. What is taxonomy? The classification of plants according to the law. Augustine Pyramus Decandolle, he was the first who identified this classification. According to this, the plants are identified, then they are classified, then they are described. So under taxonomy, they show 4 system of classification. What are the 4 system of classification? Artificial system of classification. Then natural system. Artificial system, natural system. So we are going to deal about this 2 only. Artificial system of classification. It was first introduced by Carolus Linnaeus. In his book, Species Plantarum. So, the plants are classified according to one or more morphological character. Morphology means the external appearance. How, according to the appearance, the plants are classified in one group. That is artificial system of classification. Carolus Linnaeus was the first who introduced this system. In his book, Species Plantarum. And then about natural system of classification, the plants are classified according to one or more morphology and also reproductive character. So, based on these character, the plants are coming under natural system of classification. This is introduced by Bentham and Hooker. In their book, Genera Plantarum. So this system is, now they are following the herbarium and the gardeners are always following this system of classification. So natural system of classification, under this they are following, the plants are classified according to their morphology, external appearance and also their reproductive character. Bentham and Hooker was the first man who introduced this one, this system of natural classification. So, according to the taxon, what is taxonomy? The plants are classified according to their laws. So, Augustine Pyramus and Decandolle was the first man who introduced this one. And then, how they are classified, what they are doing, the plants are first identified, then classified, and then they are described. Then, the taxonomy, under taxonomy, there are 4 type of classification. Artificial system of classification, natural system of classification, phylogenetic system of classification and modern classification. Under this, we are dealing about artificial system of classification introduced by Carolus Linnaeus. how the plants are classified according to their morphology, that is external character. Then natural system of classification, it is followed by all, that is the plants are classified according to their morphology, external appearance, and also by reproductive character. It was introduced by Bentham and Hooker, which is included in their book Genera Plantarum. And then next we move on to binomial system of classification, nomenclature. So according to this binomial, the plants are, each plant is given two name. So the plants are, bi means two, two name is given for one plant, so that is known as binomial. For example, Mangifera indica, it is the name given to the mango plant. So what they are doing mean, they are giving, this is known as genus. So genus means the plant, the mango variety. Then if we take mango, many varieties are there, though that is known as species. So they are giving one name for this name for one plant, that is mango, Mangifera indica. So two name is given for one plant. In order to get rid of the confusion, these plants are classified. So binomial system of nomenclature, it was introduced by Caspard. Then later it was implemented by Carolus Linnaeus. In his book Genus Genera Plantarum, so the plant are given two name, each plant is given two word, that is word, Mangifera it is the genus name, indica it is the species name. In order to avoid confusion about the species name, they are given the two name. So this is known as about the binomial system. Bi means two name is given to each plant. Then it was Caspard Bauhin who first introduced this one. Then later it was implemented by Carolus Linnaeus. So these are all about the plant kingdom. So far what we have learned, Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperm, taxonomy, Angiosperm and taxonomy. Next we move on to the classification. If we take, what are the classification we have learned, that is seeded plant only, seeded plant classification, gymnosperms, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. If we take gymnosperms, there is subclasses there, that is Gamopetalae is the subclass for gymnosperm. Then here it is Polypetalae. Then it is Monochlamydae. So this is the subclass. So when we take seeded plant, three types are there, gymnosperm, monocotyledon and then dicotyledon. If we take gymnosperm, Gamopetalae is the subclass, and then for monocotyledon it is Monochlamydae. Then here it is Polypetalae. And then if we take series, it is Thalamiflorae, Dicyflorae in gymnosperm, Inferae, Heteromerae and Bicarpalatae in gymnosperms, and then monocotyledon, eight series are there. So these are about the classification. And then we move on to medicinal plant, uses of medicinal plant. Some plants are useful in medicinal field. So what are the plants which are useful? First one, Acalypha indica. The leaves of the, in Tamil we can call it Kuppai Meni. The leaves of this plant are very much useful in to cure the skin disease. So the paste which is obtained from this leaf is used to cure burns on the skin. And then the juice which is extracted from the leaves of this plant is mixed with lime juice and is used to cure ringworm, which is found on the, which is one of the skin disease caused by fungus. And then next one is the eagle marmelo. In Tamil, we can call bilvam, eagle marmelos. So here, the fruit is used to cure diarrhea, dysentery, acute dysentery, diarrhea. It is chronic diarrhea, acute diarrhea. Everything is cured by the fruit of this plant. So here it is leaves. Here the fruit is useful. Tamil, we can call it bilvam. And then Solanum trilobatum. Here, the leaves and the fruits are used to cure cough. Then, it is in Tamil we can call Thoothuvalai. The leaves and fruits of this plant is used to cure cough and cold. And it is used for bronchial asthma, tuberculosis. So, all these are get rid by the Solanum trilobatum, Thoothuvalai. Then, Philanthus amaranthus. Otherwise, then Philanthus amarus. Here, it is Kedaanelli. The leaves, the entire plant is used to cure jaundice. So, what the any liver disorder, everything is cured by this Philanthus amaranthus, Kedaanelli in Tamil. And then aloe vera. Aloe vera, that is Katrala in Tamil. It becomes the family Liliaceae. And then it is used to cure piles and inflammation on the skin. And it is also used to cure ulcer. So, the leaves are useful. Here also leaves. In Solanum trilobatum, the leaves and the fruits are useful. So, these are all the medicinal, some of the medicinal plants which are used to cure some of the disease in our body. That is Acalypha indica, which is also known as, that is Kuppai Meni, used to cure some skin inflammation, ringworm and skin disease. Eagle marmolesa, that is bilvam, the fruit of this plant is used to cure dysentery, diarrhea, etc. Then Solanum trilobatum, Thoothuvalai in Tamil, it is used to cure cough and tuberculosis. Then some bronchial disorder, everything is cured by them. Then Philanthus amaranthus or amarus, it is used to cure the leaves is extracted, and then it is used to cure some skin disease. And then aloe vera, Philanthus amaranthus, the leaves are used to cure some jaundice and liver disorder. It is cured by this plant. Then aloe vera, it is used to cure ulcer and then piles. So these are all about the medicinal plant. So far we have learnt about the plant kingdom and their classification and then some useful medicinal plants. That's all about this lesson. Thank you.